Hello, welcome to my channel. My channel is all about soap making and handmade products. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and leave me comments. Don't forget to subscribe for more videos. Thank you for supporting my channel. You can also follow me on Instagram at the Scraftworks for more sneak peeks and ongoing projects. This month's challenge is to do a ghost swirl. It is such an interesting technique to change the color of the soap by adjusting the different water amounts. You can read more about ghost swirls created by Auntie Clara in the info box below. So here I am mixing two different strengths of lye solution. These lye solution have the same amount of lye but varying water amount. One at 30% and one at 45%. I labeled the container just in case I mix them up. Supposingly, the soap with high water amounts would go through gel phase while the low water would not, creating a color contrast. Then before dividing the melted oils, I'm adding my essential oil blend of patchouli and peppermint essential oils. For my design, I will divide the oils in two equal portions. Now mixing in the lye solution in the corresponding pitcher and aim to reach the same soap consistency. This time round, I have used unrefined avocado oil to add a green tint, and it gave me a bit of stress since it accelerated my soap quite a bit. I didn't really have to use the stick blender for the lower water soap, as you can see how fast the soap is reaching trace. Whereas the higher water soap needed a few pulses from the stick blender to reach a similar consistency. This time round, I have decided to use dividers for my design, pouring the low water soap on the outer portions and pour the high water soap in the middle. It was my first time working with dividers and I was definitely making a mess. Quickly smoothing the soap and removing the dividers. I originally wanted to do a Taiwan swirl, but after the swirl, I didn't like it. Then I added some random swirls that I didn't catch on camera. I then quickly cleaned up the mold and covered it with some glad wrap and placing another divider on top to keep it warm. I also used two fridge bags to keep the soap insulated. Here is the final look of the soap. The soap turned out to be the opposite of what I thought. Maybe I've used a smaller batch, I'm not too sure. Let me know in the comments and let me know your thoughts. Thank you so much for watching. Please give me a thumbs up if you liked the video and subscribe to the channel for more videos.